Hey peeps, how y'all doing today? Well, today for me is Thursday at 9:51 in the a.m. We getting ready to hit these streets. Yep, that's what's getting ready to happen. Why these orange things is not right here? They supposed to be up on the microwave. They were sitting right here. Who got the tissue right here? There you go, Shan.
Say hey. Not my hair.
You like her cat ears, y'all? Oh. What you get on me? Well, don't rub it in. So you move the tissue. Where Reen at? Nowhere to be found. Here go Rain. She look pretty. Are you wearing the white ones?
No.
Are you wearing the hoops? The hoops go nice too.
Thank you, boo. Ooh,
ooh. She got her cat ears on.
You
boo.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
She look cute.
Thank you, boo.
Like Betty Boop. And come on, Shan, let's get your color. Mm-hmm. She got her little lip gloss on.
Scared.
I don't know why she be having this little scoochie it right here though. But you wear every single tan and them little blue socks. We ain't gonna talk about those socks. We ain't gonna talk about it.
We
no, we not. I'm just keep it moving.
I love you.
So yeah, I'm waiting on the hubby. It's dark. Well, it's pretty. I think it's nice outside, ain't it?
Uh-huh. It's 65,000.
What? So yeah, I'm just waiting and everything, but since I'm waiting, I just pulled out the camera because when I come back, I'm going to finish making my video. I'm going to do my read. You went in the bathroom and I could have showed them something.
Oh, sorry.
My little spray I made. My vinegar spray.
Where at?
It's on the back of the toilet. Yeah. Because I be making them the spray, y'all. I use this bottle. These some good bottles, y'all. Don't let them go to waste. But I made me a little concoction, right? Apple cider vinegar, distilled water, aloe vera gel, and lemon essential oil. I mean, you use it down, you know, in your, down yonder. You know, because I have to go to the bathroom like a million times a day. This comes in handy. Spray it on some tissue. Bam. White. Bam. There it is. But yeah, I looked up some of the feminine DIY sprays and stuff. And this is my second one I done made. I tweaked it a little more from the first one. But yeah, apple cider vinegar. I eyeball it. It's, but it's more distilled water in here. And I say about this much water, and the rest is vinegar, apple cider vinegar, and I guess some aloe vera oil I put in here. It's a dropper. I put like a dropper full, and just dash maybe like 20 dashes of lemon essential oil. Last time I used some other kind of essential oil. I forgot the name of it. But yeah, I just wanted to show y'all that. So, I guess that's about it, peeps. I'll be back when I get back to do my read and everything. It's gloomy. I can't find y'all. I'm searching and searching, but it's not coming. Where y'all at? Well, I'm at, huh? Y'all right there. All right, I'll see y'all later on. Peace. It's 2:10 in the p.m. We just got back. So I got me a rug, y'all. I got this from Walmart. Shan, she got her shirt. The Shan's for Rainbow. $7.97. A medium. And then she got this one. A crop. shirt. A medium. 1697. And she got this to go up under it. It's $3.99. That goes up under here like that, you know. Yeah. And then I got, what's this stuff right here, y'all? Oh. Popcorn and toothbrush. Okay, but anyways. I got my gift, y'all. They bought me my gift. Rose water and ivy. So I got that. I got this, the lavender. I got this for the truck. I got our little waste basket bags. These like, what are these small?
Convict music. See, I can kind of recall a little ways back. Small trying to ball, always been black. And my hair, I tried it all. I even went flat, had a gummy curly top and all that crap. Now, just trying to be appreciated. Nappy headed brothers never had no ladies. Then I hit the barbershop real quick, had them give me little twists, and it drove them crazy. I couldn't get no job. This corporate wouldn't hire no dreadlocks. Ooh, then I thought about my dogs on the block. Kinda understand why they chose to steal and rob. Was it the hair that got me this far? All these girls, these cribs, these cars. I hate to say it, but it seems so flawed. Cause success didn't come till I cut it all off.
Little girl with the pressing curl. Age 8, I got a jerry curl. 13 and I got a relaxer. I was a source of so much laughter. At 15 when it all broke off. 18 when I went all natural. February 2002 I went on and did what I had to do. Because it was time to change my life. To become the woman that I had inside. 97 dreadlocks all gone. Like a slave at the turn of the century. It's time for us to redefine who we be. You can shave it off like a South African beauty. Got it on lock like Bob Marley. You can rock it straight like Oprah Winfrey. If it's not what's on your head, it's what's underneath. And say, hey, I am not my head. I am not your skin. I am not your expectations. No.
With the wave cap and the cops wanna harass, cause I got babes. Ain't seen nothing like that in all my days. Man, you gotta change all this fearance. They be judging one another by their appearance. Yes, India, I feel you, girl. Now go ahead, talk to the rest of the world, cause
does the way I wear my hair make me a better person? Does the way I wear my hair make me a better friend? Oh, there's a way I wear my head, determine my integrity. Oh.
Hey peeps, how y'all doing today? Okay, I'm back, y'all. Y'all. Yeah. So, it's 2:50 in the p.m. We just made it back. I showed y'all the stuff we had. Went out and got today. We've been gone a minute, y'all. So, yeah. Yeah, I had got that rug from Walmart. It was like $60. Just to bring out that black. I wanted more coverage on the floor with the rug. But, yeah, I like color. So, I'm like, that'll do. I like it. It's okay. I might pull the big one more up under the couch a little more. Back to the right. Probably had them do it. It took all four of us to lift each couch on each end, the love seat and the couch, to get that rug up under them, both of them couches. So, to move it, I've been wanting to kind of move it over, but I'm like, it's going to take all four of us again, me, the hubby, Shan, Rain, and Georgie, because one had to hold the couch on each end, the couch, the sofa, and the love seat. And then I'll push the rug. I was the one pushing the rug back and over. So, yeah. And I'm like, and once I looked at it, I'm like, dang, it should go over a little more. But I'm like, that was complicated. But it's going to, I think I'm going to have to pull it over some more, that big black rug. Because I think it's a 7x9. Yeah. But it was just too plain. So, that's that. And, yeah, I got my supplements, and I researched the supplements and everything, so, yeah, the vitamin D to help boost your immune system, so all of us gonna be taking those. It's two a day, so me, the girls, the hubby, the sonny, if he wanna take them, he could take them. And I got my collagen because I saw this commercial and then I researched it. And I really think that might have helped me out a lot. So we'll see how that goes. And I was looking for some cod liver oil, but I couldn't find it. And yeah, that's just old school right there. My mommy, the hubby mama used to get that. That's something we grew up on as kids when we got sick or whatever. And I barely was sick as a kid. And I don't really get sick like that. But y'all know, stuff be happening. And people be getting flus and stuff. And I wasn't the type that get no flu. I ain't get sick like that. You know, but just this past February, I'm like, man, I ain't playing. I'm winterizing. I gotta stock up on some more tea, some more juices. I don't like the chicken noodle camel soup, but I kind of do the Progresso because chicken noodle camel soup, I think it got MSG in it. It got something in there. But around, so I don't eat that, but sometimes I make my own too. But just to have some on hand, and the sardines is more for your iron, you know. So yeah, I ain't playing y'all for real. So, only thing left to get is, in the Super Red, the hubby was drinking that way back for energy from, you know, work and all that, and that night shift, you know, and he kind of fell off for that, and he started taking the muscle milk, which is to put some of his weight back on, because he lost a lot of weight and everything. So that works for him. And then the Super Red was the first thing. It's powder. He liked the powdery stuff. So that works good for him. So that's like $15, y'all. That muscle milk is like, what, $15. This stuff is expensive, man. For real. So, yeah. And I went to Rainbow and got the girls, Shan, her shirts. Rena had one more shirt to get, but me and her couldn't come up to the same accord about which shirt to get. So she ended up getting her some them boots, and them was like $30, Yeah, so I'm about through with them. Yeah. I'm about through with them. I got Rena Cole from Walmart. I ain't show y'all that. She ain't she good. Rena kinda she outgrew her coat. But and only thing I might have to do is get a hat, a scarf set to match the coat. But other than that, I gotta start winterizing a hubby. Cause he kinda work outside and stuff. Get him one of them coverall things again. Some long johns and stuff. I kinda winterized him good last year though. But the coverall we had got from Zimsky Brothers was over $100, but it was like the it was black, I think. I don't know. You know, he don't take care of his stuff, y'all. So he need another one, basically. And if we could find one at Walmart, he'll be getting one from Walmart. That yeah. So that's basically it. I'm on kitchen duty, washing dishes, busting suds, Rena cooking. So yeah. I guess I done caught y'all up and everything. The hubby, he's still in recoup mode. He real congested and stuff, so he coughing up a lot of cold. And with him, he throws up with his stuff. Me, I don't throw up, but when I get like the number two or whatever, I stay on the toilet. He stay over the toilet. So yeah, I'm a TMI. Look, that's real life stuff. But y'all, no, I don't want to do too much talking because I got some footage from before we left, once we got back. And so let me get into this read and everything and get her done because I'm tired. I got some water to cool my body temperature out, but y'all know, I don't been out there. Oh, they got my gift. Y'all see the room spray? Rose water and Ivy. It smells real good. I got the candle over there burning. Not right now, but that's the one I'm burning when I burn it. And I love the candle scent. Child number two put me up on that scent. And so I'm like, yeah, I really like that scent. I'm not, I don't like apple, cinnamons, and pumpkin scents. I don't know why. But I just, some when I smell them, I feel, it just make me, yeah. So they was talking about giving me some kind of pumpkin scent. Room freshener. I'm like, y'all better quit playing. I never did like those strong cinnamon apples. Those type of scents. I'm just, they kind of make me feel sick and nauseous. I don't know. It's weird, ain't it, right? Yeah, I'm a winner, baby, y'all. I like perfumey scents and flower scents. I don't even like bakery scents, food scents. I don't know. I just don't. I smell some. I be like, I be trying to get with it, but this won't let me. This the smell, the sense of smell is very particular. So y'all, let me get into this read. And today, Thursday, I told y'all that earlier, right? And so here we go. I have a nice little mouth to read. So let me get into it. Y'all ready for this read? Y'all will see this tomorrow, but it's my Thursday. Y'all ready? Okay, let's do this. We have a tendency, like the Israelites, to repeat those same patterns in our life unless we are entirely sold out to God. When things are going well, we push the envelope of what we can get away with. Again, that's how we do as kids. That's how my kids used to do. Like, stop. Stop. Go lay down. Stop. Then after a while, you be like, look, I'm gonna beat your butt. They be pushing it. Then when things start to fall apart, as they always do, we come back to him with great repentance. Oh, kids don't really say they sorry for the things they do. not when they younger. Maybe when they get older. However, every day where I live by the Holy Spirit, it is a day we can be convicted of sins and put a stop to the pattern of behavior. The book of John, chapter 16, verse 8. However, every day we are led by the Holy Spirit is a day we can be convicted of sin and put a stop to that pattern of behavior. If you sin and continue sinning, it doesn't mean the Holy Spirit is not in your life. It means you have not totally surrendered to Him and you have not listened for His voice leading you every day. Wow. We have to get free of any sin in our lives. We have to get free of any sins in our lives. And we all have it. Amen. And we say, if we say we do not have no sin, we deceive ourselves. And the truth is not in us. That's in the first book of John, chapter 1, verse 8. I have observed people who said they didn't have any sin and were not susceptible. Susceptible. Okay. I have observed people who said they didn't have any sin and were not susceptible to it. And they are the ones who have hit the greatest fall. Huge. Their pride made them blind to their own fallibility. They failed because they thought they couldn't. Wow. They failed because they thought they couldn't. And they didn't see the creeping subtlety of sin when it first began encroaching upon their lives. Wow. At the point it was no longer subtle. They refused to see it. She breaking it all down for y'all. Okay. They became so deceived that they established a human justification. They made up for themselves. Wow. This is deep. This is so deep, y'all. It can happen to anyone who does not follow the leading of the Holy Spirit. Wow. I got her done. Wow. I liked that. They became so deceived that they established a human justification system they made up for themselves. Wow. Basically saying, especially those that have the Holy Spirit, the ones that ain't connected to God like that and haven't received the Holy Spirit in their life, you free game for Satan just to be all up in your life, all up in your mind, and just running up and down you. You know what I'm saying? But when you got the Holy Spirit in your life, like I say, one sin at a time, but you got to recognize your sins. You have to, in order to get free of them. And then, like, the Holy Spirit will call you out on your sins. You know, you'll be put in the situation. Because for most of the people that got the Holy Spirit in them, know God and know that word for the most part and everything. So when the Holy Spirit call you out on a sin according to that word, and then your life ain't lining up according to that word, the Holy Spirit like, check that. It's time to get free of that. And it's funny because we do. We'll justify it. We'll justify behavior. We'll justify actions. We'll justify why we said certain things. But still, all in all, if it ain't lining up with what the word say, You got to get that right. You got to get it right and everything. And I like how she said, we create a human justification system. Ain't that what she said, y'all? Y'all, look, I'm not really good at quoting people. Not even the Bible. Not even scriptures. A human justification system. I like that. I just like those words together. Human justification system. Because we do it. We do it. But God always going to put people in your life to hold you accountable. Whether you got the Holy Spirit in you or not, it's still going to be people around you going to hold you accountable on the morals of things and on the value of things. The life morals and the values of life. And be like, why you talking to that dude and you know you married? Oh, he just a friend. We've been friends, this, that, and the other. He ain't married though. And don't try to play that friend level. Okay, he speak cool, but keep it moving. You know what I'm saying? Saying we women, we talk about the men, but women be doing some stuff too. You know, like for real, for real. Not even, you ain't even got to have the Holy Spirit in you to know right from wrong. You know, we know if you're a married woman, you shouldn't be all up in no single man face like that. We know the difference. You know what I'm saying? Man. Anyways, yeah. But, no, we've been friends. We grew up together. Y'all was kids, but y'all adults now. You know? Hey. Keep it real. Don't, no. Let's not do that. No. So, yeah. We just have to always be mindful, especially us, to have the Holy Spirit inside of us. We have to really be mindful of our actions, our words, and the people we hanging around, you know? The human justification system is free. Y'all know how we'll justify things, but we'll talk about how it's so not right and then come back with a but. That's justification right there. But see, if he hadn't or she hadn't, wrong is wrong and right is right. You know what I'm saying? Especially the people of God, we are instructed to live a certain way. We just led to be separate. We just can't be snapping off like that. We just can't. We know better. Sometimes you have to turn the other cheek. Sometimes you got to hold your peace and let the Lord fight your battle. You have to come from among them and separate yourself. And you know who you're supposed to come from among and separate yourself from. No justification system going on here. Yeah. Because God, the Holy Spirit, going to call you out on it every time. And then, not only that, if you don't change your ways, stuff going to start happening. And then, that's when it's going to get real. Why is this happening to me? I don't know why this happened to me. I didn't do nothing. I just don't come on now. Come on, come on, come on. Let's just keep everything in perspective and keep everything real. If you want change, if you want different, you have to be different. You got to change some things. Come on, come on, come on. My kids used to kill me when they be like, oh, nah, I ain't even finna go into the whole kid story because this video be too long. But anyway, that human justification system, God gonna call you out every time, whether you're a believer or not. And the ones that ain't believers, that's gonna be kind of messed up, because when he casts judgment and things just don't never seem to go right on either side, left or the right, east, south, north, and west, it just seems like so much stuff happening. You got to ask yourself, you have to keep it real. Sit down somewhere. Put yourself in time out and ask, why is this happening to me? What part am I playing? You know, because we good at playing the victim. Okay? And I'm not saying we ain't. You know, but when you find yourself a victim in a situation, you got to find a way to not stay the victim in a situation. But you got some people that play that victim card to the day they die. That's not what this is about. You know, because that could become a human justification system people sets up. You know, so you have to look at yourself. Analyze yourself. We good at analyzing other people. Analyze yourself and see what parts you have to play in things that's just not right in your life. You know, what is you allowing? What doors have you opened yourself up to? You know, who in your ear? Who ear you in? You know, all that. You got to sit down and ask yourself all these questions. The who's, the what's, the why's, the where's, the when, and the how's. Not the if, the buts, you know? So yeah, I liked it that was good and that was deep, y'all. So I hope y'all enjoyed that read and everything. I hope you took something from it. I hope y'all, you know, enjoy my little input, my insight along with the read, cause yeah, I be having. We don't even talk about this, and that just blew over my head. Seriously? We not gonna do that today. Because I'm about to end this video. So, yeah. And on that note, that's about it, peeps. I'm tired. I'm done. I've been like, I should have put my little watch on and see how many steps I took today. Because I knew a sister was stepping. Sweating and stepping. You know, I felt, look. Shoot. I'm like, I normally wear it when I go out, but I looked at it and I was like, I just didn't put it on. I don't know why. I normally put it on every Thursday when I go out. I just didn't put it on. I did a whole lot of walking a day. So yeah. So on that note, I hope everybody have a blessed Friday, a safe Friday, a productive Friday, get her done, and have a protective Friday / weekend, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Be safe out here in these streets, people, and everything. You know, it's coming up on these little pagan, these holidays and everything. You know, people start watching. They start taking it up a whole another level with the stealing. All of that, you know, they waiting and everything. So just be safe out here in these streets, be watchful, be alert and everything. And on that note, I'm out. Peace, love, share some, and what.